بسم الله. We'll enter chapter 5, and as we usually do, we'll take the vocabulary before we go into the book. So on chapter 5, we're going to take 5 verbs and a few nouns. The first verb you should all know is أكل يأكل كل أكل to eat. طلب يطلب أطلب طلب to seek. In this context that we're going to use it in, because it's food and drink, is going to be you're going to request something or order. And then we have فضل يفضل فضل تفضيل. Do you know that verb?
To prefer.
To prefer. Did you read it? Okay, he read the head. Oh, you have it written down. Along by it. That's good. He's got the verbs written down. Then we have شرب يشرب يشرب شرب to drink. حول يحول حول تحويل to change or convert or transfer something. Then we've got a bunch of nouns. So we have شراب شربة مفرد singular شراب drink drinks شربة. Then we have طعام أطعمة. Those are food. وجبة is a meal, one meal. وجبات is three or more meals. دجاجة is a chicken. دجاج chickens. سمكة is a fish. سمك is the جمع. So people think that سمك is a جمع. So they'll say أكلت سمك. I ate fishes. But the singular is سمكة. So you say أكلت سمكة تن. I ate fish. Or I ate fish. But if you say سمك, you're using the جمع now. فاكهة. Could you guess what that means? فاكهة. Fruit. فواكه fruits. وزن أوزان the مفرد and جمع for weight. كيل أكيال. It's a kilo obviously. يوم أيام. Should definitely know that.
Day
and days. سمين. Someone that's fat. Describe with them. He's fat. And سمان. It's a جمع. When I say جمع, how many am I meant? How many people or things are being described?
Three or more.
Three or more. ماء water ميات water or waters it's a جمع تمرة can you take a guess what that means تمرة dates the fruit dates and تمر dates لحم لحوم meat meats we have a lot of verbs a lot of nouns should I say in this chapter عنب أعنب it's grapes سلطة سلطات salad مائدة موائد table and tables طيف طيوف
guest,
yep that's a guest جوعان جوعة yeah someone that's hungry شبعان what's that
full.
To be full or thinking of thirsty نحيف نحاف
thin.
Thin to be thin. Okay, so let's go into our book now. And we'll start the chapter, الطعام والشراب, food and drink. We'll start the first حوار between قاسم and سالم. He says, أين تذهب يا سالم? ذهب يذهب, to go. Where are you going, O Salim? And if he was speaking to his sister, what would he say? أين تذهبين? And then he says, إلى المطعم. مطعم. Have you taken that word?
Yes.
It's a restaurant. إلى المطعم. To, إلى مطعم, the restaurant. And he says, كم وجبة تأكل في اليوم? How many? وجبة. You just took that word?
Yes.
نعم. How many meals? Even though singular, because we're using كم, or counting. How many meals تأكل في اليوم? Do you eat? In a day. How many meals do you eat in the day? He says, أكل ثلاثة وجبات. Remember, 3 to 10, we use the جمع when we're counting. أكل, there's a مدة. Why is there a مدة?
To say I.
But why is it not أكل?
Because it's two Hamza.
Yes, correct. So أكل ثلاثة وجبات. الفطور والغداء والعشاء. الفطور breakfast lunch الغداء عندنا والعشاء. So he eats three meals a day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And Qasim replies, هذا كثير جدا. This is a lot. أنا آكل وجبة واحدة. I eat one meal. He eats one meal. And he replies, هذا قليل جدا. This is very small, little. Yeah, this is very little. Because he one's eating three meals, one's eating one meal. So he says, ماذا تأكل في الغداء؟ Ahmed, ماذا تأكل في الغداء؟
What do you eat for lunch?
Yes, غداء. What do you eat for lunch or during lunch? He says, آكل الأرز. الأرز. Rice. والخبز. And bread. وماذا تأكل أنت؟ نعم, what do you eat? He says, آكل السمكة. والسلطة والفاكهة. نعم, he eats fish, fruit, salad and fruit. ما وزنك؟ نعم, remember, وزن plus the ka. ما وزنك? What is your weight? He says, 60 كيلا. 60 kilos. وما وزنك أنت? And then he replies, what is your weight? It's 100 كيل. 100 kg. And he says, أنت سمين جدا. نعم, you are very fat. And he replies, وأنت نحيف جدا. نعم, the opposite. Thin, skinny. So one's سمين, one's نحيف. So قاسم is نحيف here. And سالم is the heavy one. So he says, انظر واستمع واعد. انظر واستمع واعد. Not counting, repeat. Look, listen and repeat. So you have فاكهة, which is fruit. رز, rice, obviously in the picture. سمك, fish. خبز, bread. يأكل is now the verb, to eat. مطعم, it's a restaurant. عشاء, so dinner. غداء, so lunch. فطور, فطور is your breakfast. وجبات is your meals. وجبة, it's a singular meal. وزن, obviously weight, we can see, not a scale here, even though there's a scale there. قليل وكثير. 100 كيل, 100 كيلوز. سمين, some fat, you can see in the picture. And the other guy is نحيف. No. So now let's answer the following questions. إلى أين يذهب سالم? No. So where's سالم going? What would the answer be for that? نعم, how do you say to the restaurant? نعم, يذهب سالم إلى المطعم. من يأكل ثلاث وجبات?
سالم.
Who eats three meals? Who? سالم يأكل ثلاث وجبات. من يأكل وجبة واحدة? قاسم يأكل وجبة واحدة. ماذا يأكل قاسم في الغداء? What does قاسم eat for his lunch? What's he eating? السمك والسلطة والفاكهة. These salad, fish and fruits. ماذا يأكل سالم في الغداء? You have to go back.
يأكل سالم.
No.
اللحم.
لحم.
والدجاج.
والدجاج.
والأرز.
والأرز.
والخبز.
الخبز. Using a lot. ما وزن سالم? ما وزن سالم? What's the weight for سالم? He's 100 kilo. Yeah. Who's the نحيف and who was سمين?
سالم.
سالم.
He's
100.
سالم
100. Okay. ما وزن قاسم?
70.
It's not 70. I remember.
60.
How do you say 60?
16.
Not 16. 60. نعم. Now let's move on. Next conversation. The second حوار. انظر واستمع واعد. So this person is on a plane. She says, ماذا تطلبين من الطعام? Who's being directed? Like who's being spoken to here? نعم. أنت تطلبين. And if I was to speak to who, أنت, I would say, ماذا? تطلب. So ماذا تطلبين من الطعام? What do you translate?
Want or seeking.
نعم. What do you want or what are you ordering or seeking from the food? بعض السمك والأرز من فضلك. What was بعض?
Some.
Did you say? That's with the dal. بعض. Some fish, rice, please. And then she says, ماذا تطلبين من الشراب?
What do you want from drinks?
نعم. So what are you ordering from the drinks? Or would you ask from the drinks? ماء من فضلك. Water, please. ماذا تفضلين من الفاكهة? We take this. فضل. يفضل.
What fruit do you prefer?
نعم. What do you prefer from fruit? Or from the fruits, what do you prefer? التمر. أو العنب.
A date or a grape.
نعم. Date or grape. أو العنب. أو with a sukun on the waw. Why is there a kasra there?
Because he has to join it to her hand.
To the lamb. So there's two sukuns. التقاء ساكنين. Does anyone recall that? When there's two sukuns.
You have to make the sukun before the
kasra. Yes. So we can read the sentence. هل تشربين الشاي?
You drink tea.
Do you drink tea? She says, لا أفضل القهوة.
No, I prefer coffee.
Then she says, القهوة بالحليب. Do you take حليب?
Milk.
Is it milk?
Yeah.
Is it milk? Milk? The milk, yeah.
Because
remember, with the coffee, you drink it with milk. القهوة بالحليب. تباه with coffee with milk. And she says, نعم. القهوة بالحليب. Yes, coffee with milk. هل تريدين شيئا آخر? Do you want anything else? أراد يريد to want. And then she says, لا شكرا عفوا. What if she wants to say, yes, I want bread? How would she reply to that? Because the question is, هل تريدين شيئا آخر? تريدين, speaking to a woman, obviously. But if it, now you need to make it أنا, because it's going to be the same for the male and the female, right? نعم, أريد خبزا. أحسنت. Okay, so now, words with the pictures. ماء, قهوة, water, coffee, شاي, tea, حليب, there you have it, milk, شراب, drink. So شراب, drink, تمر, date, عنب, grape, طعام, food, يطلب, it's a verb. Do you know يطلب?
Request.
Request something. يشرب, do you know يشرب, عبدالله? Look at the picture. يشرب. The verb شرب, to drink. Ahsant, to drink. Now we'll answer the following questions. The rare occasions where you find a فعل الماضي, a past tense verb. ماذا طلبت المسافرة من الطعام? You can translate that first of all. ماذا طلبت? What did the? Yes, what did the traveler?
Order,
نعم, from the food. And the answer will be? If someone translates, then the other person has to answer the question. Who can answer? Yeah. Yeah, yeah. One?
Water.
No, from ta'am.
Oh, from food. Okay.
If you go back to the conversation. Do you know it? Talabat?
Talabat is samak wal-uzur.
Wal-uruz?
Wal-uruz.
نعم.
Yes.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay. ماذا طالبت من الشراب? What did she order? On the drinks?
طلبت من القهوة بالحليب.
Okay, we have someone said ma. Remember, I don't have the conversation, so you have to go back.
اسمع.
ما نعم, that's correct. ماذا طلبت من الفاكهة؟ ترجم. نعم, so what did she order from the fruits?
التمر أو العنب.
نعم, التمر أو العنب. Remember, you're just going back to the حوار and you're just reading and then you're writing your answers. Where are we? Oh, if it was wow, then that would be ant. O means o. هل ستشرب الشاي؟ لا. What's the answer?
تفضل القهوة.
Okay, تفضل القهوة, ستشرب القهوة. She prefers coffee, she will drink coffee. ماذا ستشرب؟ أيوة, what is she? ماذا ستشرب؟ طلبت. You can answer.
قهوة.
ستشرب القهوة. She's going to drink coffee. أين دار هذا الحوار؟ What's the answer?
مطعم.
It's, don't think it's in the مطعم.
مطعم.
نعم. ماذا تفضل أنت؟ العنب أو التمر؟ So what's the answer? Well, translate. ماذا تفضل أنت؟ What do you prefer? العنب؟
Grapes or dates.
Or dates.
Oh, we answer?
Yeah, you answer. ماذا تفضل؟
أفضل العنب.
عبد الحكيم؟
From the conversation.
No, what do you prefer? The memory said, ماذا تفضل أنت؟ أفضل التمر. أحمد؟
أفضل التمر. أفضل التمر.
Everyone prefers تمر. عبد الله, ماذا تفضل؟ تمر زو. Everyone, تمر. ماذا تفضل, القهوة أو أم الشاي؟ Remember here, the أم means أو as well. أو means أو, أم means أو. How do you differentiate?
When to use what?
Yeah, because they both mean أو. If I say القهوة أو الشاي, or here, القهوة أم.
The letter.
No. Do you know?
Is it with the kasra the one?
No, they both mean O. If you're asking a question, you use M. If I say خذ هذا أو ذلك, take this or that. But here is what do you prefer? Is a question. Do you prefer this or do you prefer that? It's a question. So use M. They're both questions. They both mean O.
So M is O, is it?
They both mean O. Both of them. If you're giving a question or a choice between two, M. If you're asking a question,
yeah.
No.
So am is used when you're, it means or whenever you're asking a question.
Yes. Here, remember, he's asking you a question. ماذا تفضل؟ Do you prefer, what do you prefer? The coffee or tea? But if I say take this or that, is that a question? You use oh.
No. Yeah, you keep
oh. With a wow. So now if you to answer this, ماذا تفضل؟ القهوة أم الشاي؟ أفضل الشاي.
أفضل الشاي.
أفضل الشاي. أفضل الشاي. أفضل الشاي. ماذا تفضل؟ ماذا تفضل؟ الشاي أم القهوة؟
الشاي.
أفضل الشاي. أفضل تي. طيب. How long do you have for Maghrib? 8 minutes. Okay, let's do the next حوار and then we'll pause. Okay, so the third conversation between the husband and wife. Assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum assalam. Ana jaw'anun jiddan. What was he saying?
I'm very hungry.
I'm very hungry. Al ghada'u ala al ma'ida.
Lunch is on the table.
Naam. Lunch is on the table. ما هذا؟ You're asking ما هذا؟ What is this? إذا السمك ولحم ودجاج وأرز والسلطة والفاكهة هذا كثير جدا. You can translate that?
Fish and meat and chicken and rice.
Rice, salad, fruit. This is a lot. We can't really translate هذا كثير جدا, can we? But you know, this is
very much.
Very much, very a lot. If I'm allowed to say that. He says, لا تأكل. She says, لا تأكل, لا تأكل, اجلس. لا تأكل, لا تأكل, اجلس.
Don't eat, don't eat, sit.
Don't eat, don't eat, sit. He says, لماذا؟ أنا جوعان. Why? I'm hungry. لدينا ضيوف. We have guests. لدينا. Remember what that means? لدى. We have guests. لدينا ضيوف من. We have guests. Who? والدي ووالدتي وأخي. Remember we took the ayah when we talked the first lesson.
My father, my mother, and my brother.
My father, my mother, and my brother. أين الضيوف? Where are the guests? في غرفة الجلوس. In the living room or the sitting room. So the third حوار. انظر واستمع واعد. ضيوف. Guest. What's a singular guest? One guest. ضيف. جوعان. مائدة. Table. سلطة. Salad. يجلس. To sit. The verb. زوجة. So wife. زوج. Husband. دجاج. Chicken. لحم. Meat. Ikram, gonna help us answer the questions. من الجوعان? Translate first.
From where is?
No, not from where. من?
He's hungry.
نعم. Answer.
He's hungry.
He's hungry. Go back.
الزوج.
أي وجبة على المائدة? What's أي وجبة على المائدة?
What meal is on the table?
No, so what meal is on the table? Is it breakfast? How do you say breakfast? Or lunch?
الغداء.
Or when dinner? So which one is it?
الغداء.
أحسنتم. ما طعام الغداء? You're close. طعام and والغداء.
What's for lunch?
Yeah. So what's the food for lunch? Who remembers? There was a lot.
السمك واللحم.
السمك واللحم.
والأرز.
والدجاج والأرز.
والسلطة.
والسلطة.
والفاكهة.
من الضيوف? Can you translate that one? من الضيوف?
Who are the guests?
Yes, who are the guests? And then he's asking, well, they ask the same question again. أين هم? Oh, no, sorry. من الضيوف? Who are the guests? Answer that. Then answer, أين هم? Where are they?
والدي ووالدتي وأخي.
How do we say her? Because it's the زوجة.
Oh,
How would he remembers? Because if you say والدي, that means. When I say والدي, what does that mean?
When you say والدي.
If I say والدي وأخي,
mine.
But remember what we're saying, we need to say her. No, that's the second person. والدها. أخوها. You said her father, her brother. You just said والدها. There's a mother left. Okay, I'll take أمها, but that's not the word you used. We use والدته. It's the same thing. You mean? نعم. أين هم? Where are they? غرفة الجلوس. وفي غرفة الجلوس. In the sitting room. أين هذا الحوار? What's the حوار?
Conversation.
conversation.
Yeah, so أين هذا الحوار? Where is this conversation? What does it say in a conversation? Does it say where it is?
No.
Okay, we'll move on from that. ماذا تأكل في الغداء? I will just leave that before Maghrib. We'll answer this question and then pause for Maghrib. Everyone can answer. ماذا تأكل في الغداء?
Are we on time?
Yeah. Gone? ماذا تأكل?
أكلت خبزا.
Okay. أكل خبزا. You said I ate breakfast. I ate bread. We use the مضارع. أكل.
أكل خبزا.
Okay. ماذا تأكل في الغداء?
أكل الأرز.
الأرز.
أكل
خبز.
أكل عنب.
عنب. Okay. Yeah. Here's something different. I like that. عبد الحكيم.
لا أكلت شيء.
ها?
لا أكلت شيء.
Okay. ما أكلت? أكل تمر. نعم. Okay, so for now we just pause for Maghrib and then we'll continue after the Salah. Okay, inshallah, we'll continue now with the next exercise. This is a very easy one. All you're doing is you're writing one on the ta'am. If you see ta'am, you write one. And if you see sharab, you write two. So for example, samak, is it one or two?
One.
Tamar? One. Ma'un?
Two.
Dajaj?
One.
Laham? Laham is two?
No, one.
One. Shayun?
Two.
Salata? One. Halib? Aruz?
One.
Khubz? قهوة فاكهة. That one's very easy, yeah? Very easy. Okay, now next exercise. Link between the two opposites. نحيفون, the opposite is نحيف is سمين. قليلون, the opposite is كثير. ينامو, the opposite is نعم, the opposite is Do we know the meaning for both sides? يستيقظ. To sleep, to wake up, which one is it? To wake up. And Samin is fat. Next page. Now we have the ordinal numbers. I think it's called that in English, sir. Ordinal numbers.
Yeah, it sounds right.
Sounds right. Okay. We have أولى, الثانية, الثالثة, الرابعة, الخامسة. First, second, third, fourth, fifth. Did we not take this before? We did. What did we take? The first, second, third, fourth, fifth. I just said that here, next page. But did we not take that previously?
No, we didn't take الأولى, we took الأول.
We took الأول, that's what I'm saying. Mm. We took الأول?
Counting.
What do we take after الأول?
الثاني.
ثالث رابع خامس
سادس
سابع ثامن
تاسع
عشر. Okay, so now we have the same thing here. What's the difference? نعم. So what's the difference between the two now, if you want to ask? Which one? Yes. So this one, feminine. So the feminine. All the non-numbers. نعم. نعم. Yes. Yes. First, second, third, fourth, fifth. We're going to, so like we did last time, we're going to split in half. We're going to do first to fifth, and then we're going to do from fifth to tenth. So remember last time, we counted from first to tenth masculine. Okay? Now we have first to fifth, but the feminine. It's basically the same. Look, الثالث. Instead of الثالث, you have الثالثة. So the تامر بوطة. الرابعة. Or الرابعة. So look at it. الأول, الثاني, or الثانية, الثالثة, الرابعة, and الخامسة. We'll do the first exercise now. رتب. وزرت مين؟ حسن أمر. Yes, order. So after الأولى, what comes after الأولى؟
الثانية.
And then after الثانية. الثالثة. Then الرابعة. And then الخامسة. So now, I mean, I'm gonna say it's root, but it's just the same as counting 1 to 10. But it's still count 1 to 10. We're saying first, second, third, fourth, fifth, until the end. So now look, if we were to go, if I scroll up, look, to the third conversation. Go back to the last conversation between the husband and wife. If you go back, next to that eye, what does it say? Next to the eye. الحوار الثالث. What does that mean then? الحوار الثالث.
The third conversation.
The third conversation. Keep going back to the conversation that we had on the plane. الحوار. What does that mean? Second conversation. Then go to the first conversation that we had. الحوار الأول. What does that mean? The first conversation. Understood? But حوار is it feminine or masculine in this?
Masculine.
So can we say الحوار الأولى?
No.
No. But if you get now a feminine word, then you can say الأولى. Is that clear? First conversation, second conversation, and third conversation. Now if I have to say the fourth conversation, what would I say? Fourth. رابع. نعم. الحوار الرابع. نعم. So we've done the first exercise. Let's do the second one now. So سل. What does that mean? سل. نعم. Join. So now we're joining between the number and the number basically. The word and the number itself. So the first one, الثانية. Where is that? Okay.
The first one.
The first one. First one? No, we're starting from there. Oh, you're doing the word first. We do the word, then we join to the number. So that is the second one, yeah? And then the second word is الرابعة.
Second to last.
Second to last, that looks like an E. And الأولى. It's the first one. أولى means first. الخامس. وخامسة. It's the middle. And الثالثة. Is second. نعم. So now he's saying connect between the two numbers. Now we have the masculine and we have the feminine together. So الثاني, connect it to his number. الثانية, second and second. الخامس, الخامسة, right underneath it. Fifth and fifth. الأول, الأولى. First and first. الرابع. الرابع. Fourth and fourth. And الثالث. Third. We connect it to third. So do you see? Remember, in Arabic we have masculine words, feminine words, masculine numbers, feminine numbers. Everything is masculine or feminine. So now we're going to go into the... They're saying that this is a grammatical exercise, but we'll just use it as a speaking exercise. So the مثال, example, he says, أين الغداء? Where is lunch? الغداء على المائدة. Lunch is on the table. Then he just replaced it. Remember, this book, it gives you the structures, and then you can take out and put in what you want. So if I say أفضل, then I can bring a word that's not even in the book. أفضل something.
أفضل something.
That's in the book. Okay. But you can bring a word from me. I see in a dictionary. You might put in here.
أفضل قاموس.
What's the yogurt that we had?
لبن.
نعم. So take a حليب and put لبن. أفضل لبن. For example like that. So the whole exercise. This one's clear. From الفطور to الحليب. Second one. ماذا تأكل في الغداء? What do you eat? أكل Then he's giving examples. You can put what you eat in your own life if you want to use it. So we have 6 examples here. Then we're going to do the third exercise. Ya'kulu at-ta'ama. What's the meaning of that? Ya'kulu at-ta'ama. He's eating. At-ta'ama. At-ta'ama. Food. La ta'kul at-ta'ama. Oh, by the way, حول. Remember we talked about حول. حول كما مثال. كما. As is in the example. I can translate as that. And he said, لا تأكل الطعام. لا تأكل. I was thinking, should I explain this? لا تأكل with سكون. Does anyone know? Did I explain the difference between لا تأكل with سكون and لا تأكل with الضمة? It's not. No. Okay. Do you know what you can do? We can. We're going to come back to this. I'm going to explain this. So this third example, or the third exercise, skip it. We're going to come back to it. Then the fourth one. تبادل السؤال والجواب مع الزميل كما في مثالين. Exchange the question answer with your classmate, as shown in the example. So we have 2 examples. ماذا تطلب من الطعام بعد السمك من فضلك؟ ماذا تطلبين من الطعام بعد السمك من فضلك؟ Do you know the difference between the 2 examples? First one is ماذا تطلب and the second one ماذا تطلبين. Yes. Do you know it? The first one? Do you know the difference between the 2 examples? So the first one you're speaking to one man and the second one you're speaking to one woman or girl, doesn't matter. Nah, so change it as is in the example, and then you use salata, al-lahm, al-dajaj, whatever is in the example. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go back to the other example, inshallah. So we'll do the exercise now. You can enter your groups. Okay, so let's complete. Let's finish the first one. Ain al-ghada. You'll say al-ghada'u alal ma'ida. Ain al-futur. Where's breakfast? Al-futur alal ma'ida. Next one. أين العشاء؟
العشاء
على المائدة. أين السمك؟
السمك على المائدة.
السمك على المائدة. أين الدجاج؟
الدجاج.
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 نعم.
على المائدة.
على المائدة. جمع مائدة.
تيبو.
أين الماء؟ الماء على المائدة. أين الفاكهة؟ الفاكهة على المائدة. أين القهوة؟ أين الحليب؟
الحليب على المائدة.
نعم أحسنتم. Next exercise. ماذا تأكل في الغداء؟ آكل اللحمة. هشام ماذا تأكل في الغداء؟
آكل السمك.
ماذا تأكل في الغداء؟ Someone else.
آكل الدجاج.
آكل الدجاج. I eat chicken. ماذا تأكل في الغداء؟
أكل السلطة.
أكل السلطة. ماذا تأكل في الغداء؟ أكل الأرز. ماذا تأكل في الغداء؟ أكل الخبز. نعم أي بريد. ماذا تأكل في الغداء؟ أكل الفاكهة. I eat fruit. Going to exercise 4. ماذا تطلب من الطعام? Same for second one. ماذا تطلبين من الطعام? Let's do the first one. You say بعد السمك من فضلك. Some fish please. من فضلك please. So هشام ماذا تطلب من الطعام? You say for the first one? Exercise 4. You say? بعد.
بعد السمك من فضلك.
The next the example.
بعد السلطة من فضلك.
نعم some salad. ماذا تطلب من الطعام? Someone else? بعد اللحم سميت ماذا تطلب من الطعام يوسي بعد الدجاج من فضلك ماذا تطلب من الطعام بعد الأرز إذا أرزي وأرزة أرزو أرزي وأول إن أجريمنت إذا بعد الأرزي And if I say, we're all in green, by the way. And if I say, أكل الأرز وأرز أرز أحسنت. And for the second one is the exact same thing. I don't know why they've written the words out twice. Or they put two men and two women. ماذا تطلبين من الطعام? The answer is exactly the same. As long as you understand ماذا تطلبين من الطعام. Then we have, in fact, should I come back for this? Now, okay. You know what we're going to do? I'm going to go back and explain exercise three. It's going to come in Medin book two, but we can go through it. You know when, on this page here, this page, write out the verbs in the fourth one, only the fourth, from ta'kulu until to shahid. Just write out as it is, yeah. Don't write the la and don't write what comes after it, al-ta'am, just the middle one. Ta'kulu until to shahid. I'll zoom in. That's what you have to write out. In fact, sorry, write each one out twice. So write ta'kulu twice underneath each other or next to each other, is up to you. Write ta'kulu, ta'kulu, tashrabu, tashrabu. Just give you a few moments to do that. All right. So on one section, so you've written every verb twice. On one of them, in fact, all of them, write la in front of the verb. Write la, just write la, la, five times. Khubayb. Did you write Ula? Okay, so at the end of each verb, put a dhamma. On the last letter of each verb, so for ta'kulu, the end of ta'kulu, write a dhamma. Because ta'kulu, tashrabu, taknusu, taghsilu, tushahidu. Put a dhamma on the end of it. We all done that. Put a dhamma on every the end, the last letter of every word, put a dhamma. So it should be ta'kulu, dhamma at the end, tashrabu, with a dhamma, taghsilu, taknusu, tushahidu. It should be a dhamma on each verb. For the second one, you've written each verb twice, sah? Put la, but sukun at the end. La on all of them, and sukun. So one set of verbs will have la, and it ends with a dhamma. Once the second set, la, and it ends with sukun. Is that clear? So if you were to read it to me, one should say la ta'kulu, and the other one should say la ta'kul, ending on a sukun. La tashrabu, and la tashrab, ending on sukun. Because they brought it a bit too early, but I'm going to try to explain what we've done. In exercise three, I think it was. Have you all done it? Okay, so on the right, or the first row, a bunch of verbs you wrote ends with a dhamma, sah? This is la and nafiya. It is the negative la where you're negating something. So it's called la and nafiya. negative la. Negative, negative la. You just say negative la. And the second one, the ones that are ending in sukun, that is la and nahiya. There's two types of la that we can use. One's nafiya, one nahiya. One's negating, and one is for prohibiting. Prohibiting. You understand it? I'm going to give examples as well. I just want you to write it down, and then I'll give the examples.
One is saying that there isn't any.
Yeah. So.
The one with the dhamma shows.
Okay. So now, have you written that all down before I explain? So the one with the dhamma, la ta'kulu, I'm saying, you are not eating. I'm negating something. La tashrabu, you are not drinking. La taknusu, you are not sweeping. La taghsilu, you're not washing. La tushahidu, you're not watching. So I'm negating something that you're doing. I'm negating your action. But the one, the second la, the nahiyah, prohibiting. I'm telling you not to do something. That's the one that ends in the sukun. So if I say la ta'kul, not la ta'kulu, la ta'kul, don't eat. La tashrab, la taknus, don't sweep. La taghsil, la tushahid, don't watch. For example, here, let me find another example. لا تجلس هنا. لا تجلس. I didn't say لا تجلس هنا. I said لا تجلس هنا. Don't sit here. لا تأكل هنا. Don't eat here. You understand the two? The first and last quote? And the second one is? Did you say that twice? نافية and ناهية. Is that understood? Is there anyone that's not understood the two لا? So you see one end la sukun, what's that ikram? La, and then the verb end is sukun. It's prohibiting something. You're saying do not do it. La with a dhamma, you're negating something. All right, so let's go back now to the exercise that we skipped. It was exercise 3. Now, by the way, now here, there's a kasra in the green sentence. So it's the ya'kulu ta'ama, la ta'kuli ta'ama. There's a kasra there because there's two sukuns that are coming together. Remember, it's a la ta'kul with a sukun. But then, al-ta'am, what's on the alif, the lam? So can we pronounce la ta'kul and then the word that comes after it? No. So iltiqa' sakinain, the meaning of two sukuns, we put a kasra on the first. So la ta'kuli ta'ama. What does لا تأكل الطعام mean? Do not eat the food. But if you remove the التقاء ساكنين just for this, it will be لا تأكل الطعام. لا تأكل. Do not eat food. Then the second one, يغسل الملابس. He's washing the clothes. You'll say, do not wash the clothes. You'll say, no, directly. Because remember, يغسل is هو. تغسل أنت. You say لا تغسل الملابس for phonetic reasons, but without التقاء ساكنين لا تغسل. Do not wash. يكنس. Obviously, he's washing, and your washing is تكنس. Do not sweep. لا. لا تكنس. And if a word comes after it, لا تكنس الغرفة, do not sweep the room. يشرب الحليب, he's drinking milk. Do not drink. لا تشرب with a سكون. And then if حليب comes after it, we'll pronounce it as لا تشرب. لا تشرب الحليب. يطلب السمكة. يطلب السمكة, he's ordering fish. Do not order. Do not order will be? No, first of all, just say, do not order.
Why would you say, la tashra
because there's with a kasra, because now there's two sukuns that I'm eating. And in order, for phonetic reason, in order to read, we have to put a kasra, the first sukun. This is for most, this is for any time there's two sukuns, not just in this concept that we're taking. That's why, for the first example, I want you to give me just the nahiya, then we'll pronounce anything that comes after it. So do not order will be, how would you say do not order? La talaba yatlubu. You just say la tat la tatlub. That's it. La tatlub. Like what means? Do not order. Then obviously a samak comes after it. You have to say do not order whatever you're not ordering. La tatlub samaka. Yaqra as-sahifata. He's reading the newspaper. Do not read. لا تقرأ. Do not read. And then الصحيفة, so it become لا تقرأ الصحيفة. يشاهد التلفاز. Here's a good one. You might be against watching TV, so you say لا تشاهد التلفاز. Do not watch television. Is that understood? And this concept, it will come in lesson 15 of Al-Arabiyyat Medina book. لا تكتب بالقلم الأحمر. لا تكتب. What does that mean? لا تكتب. بالقلم الأحمر. With the red pen. لا تخرج من الفصل. لا تخرج. Don't leave the classroom. And by the way, لا تعبد الشيطان. لا تعبد. نعم لا تعبد. Do not worship الشيطان. لا تعبد الشيطان. Do not worship الشيطان. And الالتقاء ساكن هي. In this example, لا تخرج من الفصل. How do you say from? من. The noon has سكون. صح. الفصل. You can't pronounce it. لا تخرج من الفصل. As an example. So. من ال. نعم. So, is there any questions on this لا that we've taken? The two types of la, they were negation, nafiya, and nahiya. Negation and prohibition. Prohibition start ends with a sukun, and the negation where you're saying you're not doing something ends in a dhamma. So, if there's any questions, we can take them. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen.